Hi guys, it's me Karen and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Today I'm going to do a picture in The Jewelry Box by Hannah Carlson. And I wanted to do this page over here. I was just going through some of my books and I saw this, and this is probably one of the reasons I bought this book, other than the fact that I love all her books. So we're going to work on the little vase here, and I'm going to kind of do it in kind of an antique porcelain vase type thing in kind of a Victorian kind of coloration. So I'm going to move the camera down and we will get to work. Okay, we're going to start working on the little swirl part here first, and we're going to go in with ivory. I'm using polychromos, and we're just going to go down and lay the ivory on here. Well, I hope you're all doing well. I'm going to try to give this a nice antique-y look on all of the things except for the little micies. They're going to look like regular mice. They don't have anything special on them that I can make them into little antique mice or old-fashioned mice. Okay, everybody got a little ivory on there. I'm leaving one edge of that lighter for the kind of highlight area. And I'm going to bring in some raw umber here. And we're going to go down this line. I need to get it sharpen that just a little bit. There we go. So I get down this line close to it as I can. We're just tracing it basically on one side of that line. I'm going to bring a little bit of that up as a shadow. Very light touch coming up into the ivory. Darker on the line, and then just a real light touch coming up from that. Are you all getting ready for the new year? It's coming up pretty soon. Sooner than I'd like, but we'll see if we can stay up late this year. It's been kind of a rough couple of weeks here. Kind of like to relax a little bit. Okay, we're gonna make it a little darker down here, and I think I'll lighten that line up right there with the clean eraser. Don't want it so dark there. So then we're just going to turn the book a little bit. And we're going to take it this way and bring it up a little bit. And up the top and bring it down lightly. It's going to be shadowed by that piece. When we get to it. There we go. Go back over it with the ivory. It'll soften and blend that out a little better. Okay, then we will bring white. I got my Holbein white here. It's the soft white. We're gonna put a little of that in the center here. There we go. Soften those black lines a little bit. Just give it more of a shine. That's all we're going to do to the center section. We are going to make these sections here and here black. So I need to get out my black. Should be here somewhere. And probably a dark blue. Dark indigo. That will help us with a little bit of the highlight in there. So dark indigo first. And we have our shine kind of going on this side. So we will put the indigo on this side here. And doing so, we will bring it down to the bottom and do it down in here. Okay, we're going to go in with the black. I'm going to go lightly first and then just put a couple of coats on it. So make sure the black is on there and blends in with that blue. change direction. Put another layer on. I just find it easier to do layers than put heavy pressure on it and get it all done at one time. You could do that if you want. But I prefer just putting light layers on it until I get the color I want. Saves my wrist and my fingers. We're going to take the blue back in here. I know I've gone over the little things, but they'll erase nicely or nice enough for me. Then I'm going to go back over it with the black. Put a little bit more pressure on it just to get a solid black there. And then just push the blue in there a little harder too. Still want to see it, but it needs to be as dark as the black. And I did leave a light line there, which we're going to go in with a lighter gray color. I'm not sure which one. What I got? I have a cool gray too. We'll see how that does. And that gives us a nice little light line there. We'll just blend that out. And into those areas. Okay, I'm gonna do the same thing with the bottom, but I can do that off camera. But it's gonna be that dark of a color. Now, any places that we have that are covered in here with some black, I want to kind of erase a little bit. Just so I know where that filigree stuff goes. Okay. Now we're going to take some colors here and I'm going to do the filigree part, which we're going to do in gold colors. So, a yellow ochre first. And we'll put that on the highlighted areas of these things. And we'll just go around this and get some gold in there. Very lightly go over the white areas just to give a very soft, light yellow look in there. We're going to go in and add shading to that. Burnt sienna. We're just going to use it in the little tiny areas down here and then bring it up. Then we will bring in walnut brown. I'm going to sharpen that up a little. Just get into the nooks and crannies in here. Kind of bring in and out into the black area also. Then we will get a lighter yellow color here. I'm going to find one, dark Naples ochre. Sharpen that up, and then we'll highlight these areas here. Leave some of them a little lighter. And just touch it with that pencil. Then we will take in a little ivory. Sharpen that point, and we're just going to highlight some of that with the ivory instead of the white. Okay, I need to darken this just a little bit more, so we're going to bring in light yellow ochre here. Only color I'm missing is my green gold. I'll just brighten up some of those areas a little bit. Oops, pressing a little too hard there. Okay, we're going to bring some of that down in here too. All right. If you don't think your black is dark enough, you can go back over it. Just put a little more pressure in there. I did go over it with the gray. And add it in those darkest areas there. And there we go. I am going to put a little bit of diamond stickles on that also when we get down to it. Down at the bottom, We do the same thing. Start laying down the black. The area down here, we will make this piece black. Put in the indigo. Bottom should be gold. Try not to go out the lines like I do. Get rid of that little line, it's gonna bug me. Just work on it until you like the color shading you get. Try not to go over those little filigree lines that we're gonna go in with the gold color again. Okay, and our gold colors. It was light yellow ochre. We're going with the sienna, burnt sienna. We're also going to be putting this down here, so I should probably put some in there. Okay, a little bit of the walnut brown, the darkest spots. Bring in the green gold. A little bit of our bright yellow. Our ivory. Thank you. this other side here. That, not that color. We'll just go in with the burnt sienna here. And I'm gonna add a little more in here. To get it to match the one up top, and just a little bit more. There we go. Got to do the handle. So we're going to go up here, add in the shading down here. Green gold, I think. Yep. Sienna. the whatever other color I have down here, the light yellow ochre. Dark Naples ochre. Just making sure all those colors are in there. The walnut. Use a smaller pencil than this. Here we go. Walnut brown. Just make sure our dark areas are dark. Shadow under his feet. Under his mouth. Okay, then we'll just touch it up with some ivory here. And so you can see it, I'm going to go ahead and put the stickles on there, and then I'm going to have to call this one. Let me get the right one. We're going to use diamond because the diamond will actually accent the gold that we put on here. So I'm going to start from the top up here. think we'll put a little here in the black for the highlight going up here. And a little down on these. There we go. Okay. Now, if you can see all the shine on there, but that's what it's going to look like. We're going to kind of do antique on this purse too, in a deep red with a black. And then, of course, we're going to have to do the roses, probably in the same deep red up there. But that'll come in a different part. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section down below, and I will get to them as soon as I can. Take care, everyone. Bye now.